I'm the best there is at what I do. And what I do isn't very nice. It's okay, folks. It's not really. It's just box and all that. But anyway, hi there, everyone. Pinball Wizard 192, aka Simon Thompson here. And I'm back with another, and again, I'm back with another trailer reaction video. Only this time, it's Hugh Jackman's final outing as Wolverine in the upcoming Marvel movie in the X-Men universe named Logan. So let's get right on with it.
Logan, what did you do?
Patrick's back, yeah.
The same as it was. Mutants. They're gone now.
I hurt myself today to see if I still feel.
I focus
on the pain. The only thing that's real.
Where is she?
Beneath the stain.
She's like you.
Of time,
very much like you.
Yeah. Come on, that's gonna be this 23.
She needs our help.
You are
someone to come along.
Someone has come along. I am still right here. And you could have it all. My empire of dirt. I will let you down. I will make you hurt. I will keep myself. I would find
Damn.
A way.
Logan, you still have time.
Wow, it's just, sorry, so good, with the Johnny Cash song in it, it's so beautiful put together with that story, how the story is put into that footage right there, it's brilliant. I just hope that this is the good Wolverine movie we are hoping for, right? So let's get right on with the information. Let's see what this is all about. So it's like, so basically the movie is Logan. It's coming out in March 3rd, 2017 in USA. I'm not sure about the UK release date yet. I don't know that yet. It's the 10th installment of the X-Men film series. And it's the third and final Wolverine solo movie. And it is actually based, and if you can tell, it is actually based on the comic book series Old Man Logan by Mark Miller, which I haven't read yet, but I really, really, really want to because I heard it's really good. And also, again, it's directed by James Mangold, which directed the previous Wolverine movie, which was, you know, took part in Japan. Which I thought was quite entertaining, even though some people will have mixed feelings about the ending, which I can understand. So the plot, it's set in the year 2024. Logan's healing abilities are slowly fading away, and Professor Charles Xavier has some kind of disease that causes him to forget some kind. The X-Men have lost when Nathaniel Essex and his corporation has left the world in ruins. Which, you know, since we got a glimpse of Nathaniel, the corporation run by Nathaniel Essex in the end credit scene to X-Men Apocalypse. Logan must defeat Essex with the help of a young girl named Laura Kinney, a female clone of Wolverine. And yeah, if you can be sure, if it's true, then yes, X-20... You probably know it's true, you know, since, like, somewhere in the trailer, you see, like, two metal claws, shinks coming out, you know, like, you know, and Wolverine is blocking them with his famous free metal claws. So, yeah, Laura Kinney, who is played by Daphne Keane, is also X-23, a young mutant who is the female clone of Wolverine, created from his own DNA. And usually we have Hugh Jackman back as James Hollett, or, you know, who is famously known as Logan, aka Wolverine. Patrick Stewart, again, as Charles Xavier, aka Professor X, sorry, I will say Oak. he was the founder and former leader of the X-Men. This is the last movie starring them two both together, which is it's really good. There's also Boyd Holbrook as Donald Pierce, a relentless, calculating, and intense head of security for global enterprise and leader of the Reavers. The Reavers are like a team of cyborgs. I never even heard of them. They were like in the X-Men comics from, you know, they first appeared in Uncanny X-Men 229 in May 1988. They were created by Chris Claremont and Mark Silvestri. I don't know how much impact they're going to have on the story. Maybe they probably appeared in No Man Longer, but I don't know. I need to read that soon. also starring Richard E. Grant as Dr. Xander Rice, surgical head of the Project Transigen, which created X-23. I don't know how much anyway. And also we got Stephen Merchant as Caliban, a mutant who helps Logan with taking care of Charles Xavier. Caliban, I don't know what his abilities are, but I'm for that ring as well, but anyway. There's also Eric Larsen, Ellis Neal, and Elizabeth Rodriguez. Those three actors, they've been cast in unspecified roles. We'll know very soon, later, maybe next year, maybe in the new year, what they're playing. And we also know that, Nathaniel Essex, aka Mr. Sinister, will make his first on-screen appearance in the film. And I hope to make a video about which actors who will play this role in this upcoming Wolverine movie. So yeah, I feel like this is going to be a great movie and a fantastic ending, you know, to the you know, to Hugh Jackman's acting as Wolverine, because he was a perfect choice, even though he's a Broadway dancer, you know, sort of Broadway actor and dancer, but still he plays the badass mutant so well, and I really like adored him so much playing, you know, one of my favorite superheroes. I really love like the graph. I'm really looking so forward to see that this movie is R-rated. Yeah, it's definitely R-rated. I can tell because of when Logan, you know, put his metal claws in a guy's head through his chin. I was like, whoa, that's just deep. I'm like, that moment got me so excited. It felt, you know, and like the relationship between Logan and this and X-23, I'm just so looking forward to seeing that, as, you know, it's just these three mutants banding together, you know, just to try and to fight against a world that hates them. It's just so a way to survive. It's so beautiful. It's like The Last of Us, but in X-Men style. So yeah, I am really looking forward to this. I hope you enjoyed this video. Be sure to like, subscribe, and if you have any feelings about this trailer, feel free to give your thoughts below, your thoughts in the comment section below. And I'll see you all next time. Take care.